हेलो किड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई होप ऑल आर रिफाइन। के सो टुडे इज़ योर मैथ्स क्लास एंड आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर एकता शर्मा। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू मैथ्स एंड इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर न्यू चैप्टर। सो दिस इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 3, सब्ट्रैक्शन। ओके, इन चैप्टर नंबर 3 वी हैव लर्न सम टॉपिक्स, हाउ टू राइट numbers in column and subtract, word problems and subtraction with regrouping. Today in chapter 3 subtraction we are going to learn a new concept, comparing with the help of subtraction. So kids, let's start our new topic, comparing with the help of subtraction. With the help of subtraction we can compare two numbers and find out by how much one number is greater than the other number. Okay, let's see example. Seema has 17 dolls and Amrita has 23 dolls. Who has more dolls and by how much? Okay, so Seema has 17 dolls, 17, and Amrita has 23 dolls. Which is bigger number and which is smaller? So 17 is a smaller and 23 is a bigger. Okay, we will write first bigger number. So Amrita has 23 dolls. So Amrita has more than dolls. Okay, Seema has 17 dolls. So we will write in bottom 17. Okay, so Amrita has 23 dolls. See, we will write here 23. We will write 3 in ones place and write in 2 tens place. Okay. Seema has 17 dolls. We will write 7 in one side and 10, 1 in 10 place. Okay. Now Amrita has 23 dolls and Seema has 17 dolls. Now we have to find out how many dolls Amrita has more. Okay. So we will subtract, because we have to compare two numbers. Okay, here is a 3 and here is a 7. Because 3 is a smaller number and 7 is a bigger number, we cannot subtract. We will borrow 110 from 210. Okay, we will take 110 and we will write here 1313. Okay, now we will write here 1. Okay, so we have to subtract 7 from 13. We get 6. Okay, now 1 minus 1, we get 0. So Amrita has 6 dolls more from Seema. Okay, so we will write in answer, Amrita has 6 dolls more than Seema. How many dolls Amrita has more? Amrita has 6 dolls more than Seema. So with subtraction we can compare, with the help of subtraction we can compare two numbers. Okay kids? So kids, our next topic is checking subtraction using addition. Now we will check subtraction by using addition. Okay kids, we know 5 plus 3 is equal 8, 8 minus 3 is equal 5. They are related facts. They make a fact family. We can use addition to check our subtraction. In the above example, 8 minus 3 is equal 5. 8 is our minuend, 3 is our subtrahend, and 5 is our difference. Now we will check how will you check our subtraction is correct or not. To check our subtraction by adding the difference and the subtrahend is equal to minuend. Okay, we start with the difference and add the subtrahend. Here difference is 5, with this we have to add subtrahend 3. So 8 minus 3 is equal what? 8 minus 3 is equal 5. 8 is our minuend, 3 is our subtrahend, and 5 is our difference. So we will write our difference here and we will write our subtrahend. Okay, Now we will plus 5 plus 3 is equal 8. If the sum is equal to minuend means we did the problem correctly. Let me explain with an example. So kids, I am taking an example. The number are 78 minus 36 what? So for that, first we have to perform subtraction, kids. Okay, first we will arrange the numbers according to their places. Okay, so kids, first we will arrange ones place. We will write 8 from 78 and 6 from 36 in one place. We will write 8 in one place and on the top, and we will write 6 in bottom. Okay, now we will write 7 in 10 place in the top, and 3 we will write in the bottom. Okay, we will write 7 in top place and we will write 3 in bottom. Okay, now look at the ones column. What is the top number? Okay, the top number is 8 and the bottom number is 6. So kids, I told you all that you have to start counting the fingers after the smaller number till you reach the bigger number. Now we have to counting after 6, 7, 8, 7, 8. Okay kids, so 6 is the smaller number, so start counting the fingers after 6. So how many fingers we counted? 7, 8. 2 fingers. Okay, so we will write here 2. 2 in the ones column we will write. Next, we will move on the tens column. Here is the smaller number is 3 and bigger number is 7. So we have to start counting after 3. So start counting after 3 and stop at 7. Write 4 in the tens column. We will write 4 in tens column. Now next steps. Okay, so 78 minus 36 we get 42. So our difference is 42. Now next step, what we have to do? We have to check whether we did the problem correct or not. For that, we have to write the difference. Our difference is 42. We will write here our difference 42. So the difference obtained is 42 and the subtrahend is our 36. We will write our subtrahend 36. Okay. So kids, now we will write 42 in the top and 36 in bottom. Now we will add 42 plus 36. Okay, because we are checking our subtraction. So here is 2 and here is 6. After 6 we have to forward 2 countings. 7, 8. We get 8, we will write here. In 10 place we have 4 and 3. We have to forward after 3 4 counting. 4, 5, 6, 7. So we will write here 7. So kids, our subtraction is correct because we get the minuend. So kids, here is the sum is also minuend and the sum is also 78 and the minuend is also 78. Hence we did the problem correctly. So kids, in this topic we have learned how to check subtraction by using addition. Okay. So kids, our next topic is addition and subtraction on number grid. In this topic we will learn a new concept, that is how to add and subtract using a number grid. Yes, it is really very, very interesting concept. And in this concept, you don't need to do anything. You need to jump only. So in this type of question, what we have to do? We are given the number grids. First of all, let's understand how to do addition this on number grid. So we are going to do the addition. Okay. So in addition, what we have to do? We need to mark the first number and then we need to jump. So kids, let's start how to use number grid. So we are adding 8 plus 20 in a number grid. Addition on number grid, we have to jump. We need to jump. Okay, so we will jump 2 tens from the 8. Here is 8. We will jump on 18 and then we will jump on 28. Okay, so 8 plus 20 is equal 28. Okay, now 23rd plus 4, we have to jump from the 23rd. 4 jump from the 23rd. Okay, so 1 2 3 4, we get 27. So 23 plus 4 is equal 27. 46 plus 23, we have to jump 2 10 and plus 3 ones. So 46, from 46 we will go on 56, then 66, and then 3 ones, 1 2 3, we get 69. 59 plus 40 is equal 99. How to? Okay, so 59 we have to go 4 10. Okay, 59, then 1 2 3 4, 59 plus 10 69, plus 10 79, plus 10 89, then plus 10 99. So 59 plus 40 is equal 99. So let's see example. 10 so ones, 3 tens and 0 ones, 3 tens and 1 10. Okay, now we have to add 3 10 and 1 10. So we have to go on 30 and we have to jump 1 10. We have to one jump. What we will get? We get 40. So 30 plus 10, we get 40. Okay. Next is subtraction on a number grid. When we want to use the number grid for subtraction, we start from the first number and move backward as many spaces as the second number. In case of subtraction, we need to move towards back. We are going to do subtraction. Okay, so in subtraction, what we have to do? We have to mark the first number and then we need to go backward. So kids, now we are using subtraction on a number grid. So when we are using number grid for subtraction, we start from the first number and move backward. In addition, we go forward, and now in subtraction we go backward. Okay, so 30 minus 2, what we have to go 2 tens backward. Okay, we have to 30 minus 2, so we have to go 20 backward. So here is a 30. Now we will go 210 backward. 210 backward means 30 se hum kahan par backward jayenge? 20, then 10. So 30 minus 20 is equal 10. 100 minus 40. Now we have to 100 minus 40. We have to go 410 backward from the 100. Now we will go backward 90, 80, 70 and 60. So 100 minus 40, we get 60. Let's see example. 32 minus 12. We have to go backward 32 till 12. Okay, so here is a 32 and we have to go backward 12. Okay, so 32 we will go backward on 22, and then we have to count 2. We have to go backward 2. 1, 2. So we get 20. We get 20. This is the subtraction on a number grid. Kids, our topic subtraction is complete. Now your chapter 3 is complete subtraction. Thank you.